that we use.
And everybody in the room knows what gamification is.
Yeah, raise your hand if you've never heard the term gamification before.
Wow.
There you go.
It's actually really surprising to us. Cause,
we need to market better.
Yeah, we clearly obviously need to market better, but we also need to get our Google ranking for gamification higher. I don't know if you guys search that. But so here's the idea, that we're going to talk a little bit about human motivation and some of the science behind it. This is a hour and a half presentation shrunk down into about 7 minutes. So I would be more than happy to come and present this to you in full. We also have a webinar version, which we actually did for Hyatt recently. And Chris Worth from Hyatt is going to talk a little bit about kind of how they use Snowfly and what their program looks like. So if you'll go to the next slide, Eli. Anybody know who this guy is? Anybody take psychology in college and remember? Anyone? No? All right, this is a famous American behavioral psychologist named B.F. Skinner. B.F. Skinner did some experiments where he used rats and pigeons. And what he figured out was that there were four different ways, basically, that people, or his subject in this case, responded to, and if you'll click to the next slide, reinforcement or punishment. Okay? So as humans, the way that we interact with one another, you can have positive and negative reinforcers, right? So punishment or positive reinforcement. And unfortunately, in the workplace, more often than not, the thing that drives our employee improvement, right, is based upon negative reinforcement. Where somebody didn't do something exactly right, or they messed up with a policy, or they didn't show up on time, or ever, right? And what do? We have a policy manual that has every possible scenario in there, right? For what happened and what we need to do to take care of that. But instead, what if we were more on the other side, and we were reinforcing the positive behavior? And enacting behavioral change through that positive reinforcement. Next slide here. And what Skinner did through his experiment, and I am not going to go through it because it's really complicated, not complicated, but it's really complex and interesting, and I can talk about it for an hour plus because it just fascinates me. But this was kind of the crux of his finding. And it was somebody over here, I think at this table, you guys mentioned about the immediacy of the feedback, right? So, the best way to change behavior is to implement the reinforcer as close to when that behavior was performed as possible. So think about it this way, and I am not going to say that your employees or your children are like dogs, but for a second I'm going to say they're like dogs. If you were to give your dog a treat 2 weeks after he rolled over, does your dog have any clue why he's getting that treat? No, not a clue. And it's especially true with animals, right? We have to reinforce that behavior right away. The dog pees on the carpet, no, don't do that. Dog goes over, you give him a treat, yeah, so we're gonna reinforce the behavior as positive or negative.